وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, the contradiction that I want to speak about today is هجر الإنسان من أجل الله وهجره من أجل حق النفس. Boycotting a person for your own sake. You actually boycott someone for your own sake because he did something to you you didn't like. He said, I'm not gonna talk to you. But if that person did something against Allah Azza wa Jalla, you were like, akhi, look, you know, it's subjective how you look at it. You make excuses for that person. But when it comes to the religion, so when it comes to you, sorry, when he oppresses you or he wrongs you, those excuses don't exist. You don't make these justifications for him. Straight away you boycott him. I know what he meant. I know what he intended. I know what the ulterior motive that he had. I know this person inside out. That's what you say. But if he did something against Allah's religion, if he was committing atrocities and haram and sins and crimes in Islam, ya akhi, wallahi, look, there are differences of opinion in this issue. He's holding on to a view of a scholar. Akhi, you know, the thing is, you know, we have to be tolerant as Muslims. We have to overlook our differences. وَهَكَذَا You make ma'adhir for him, okay? You make excuses for him. But those excuses are out of the window when he does something to you. That's a contradiction. That's a clear-cut contradiction that many of us fall into. And this is worrying and it's scary, to be honest, because what you're now doing is that you're taking the mistake and the fault that the person does towards you greater than the wrong and the mistake that he does towards Allah Hu Azza wa Jalla. And that's scary. That's worrying. Do you think you're more valuable? Do you think you're more important than Allah and His Messenger? So the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, as it's authentically narrated from him, is that he never got angry for himself alayhi salatu wasalam. He wouldn't. But if the rights of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala was exceeded and someone, you know, overstepped their boundaries in the rights of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the Prophet will get angry. He will get angry, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it was also transmitted that Umar radiallahu anhu, Umar ibn al-Khattab, Faruq hadhi al-Ummah, Umar got angry with a man once. After, you know, he said something to Umar, and Umar became very angry. And Umar stood up, he wanted to do something to him. Very angry. The anger was clear on Umar's face. And he was full of rage and anger. So someone saw Umar in that way, and the anger that was on his face. So he recited the verse to him, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ خُذِ الْعَفْوَ خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ Take with you forgiveness. Come with forgiveness. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ And command that which is good. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ And turn away from those who are ignorant. Turn away from those who are ignorant. Umar radiallahu anhu, the minute he heard that verse recited, it was like the anger was stripped from his face and it was taken out of his face. Umar radiallahu anhu, it was literally taken out of his face. And the narration mentions Umar radiallahu anhu was an individual that whenever the boundaries of Allah were mentioned or the boundaries of Allah were set, he would never exceed his boundaries. So he heard the verse, it penetrated, touched his heart, and now straight away he implemented it. So he totally and utterly, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, forgave him and turned away from him. And that's how we should be as Muslims. What should we be? People who don't hold grudges. We forgive. Yani people do mistakes, errors, fault, no problem. As long as it's not the rights of Allah. Now I am no way, shape or form saying to you that everybody who wrongs you, still be friends with them. The concept of being friends with people is a totally different thing. Who do you want to be friends with? Whose companionship you want to be in? Who do you want to be sitting with? That's not what I'm saying. There might be some people that you just have conflict with them excessively and a lot. So I wouldn't encourage you to sit with them where it always cause problems. But don't boycott. Boycotting is not the case. They just, Salaam alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. How are you? Is everything good? Yes, no problem. Khalas, keep it moving. Companionship lakin is not necessary for everybody. You can't be friends with everybody, and not everybody are you gonna see eye to eye with. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Al-arwahu juludun mujannada ma ta'arafa min ahtalafa wa ma tanakara min ahtalafa." Yani the souls, they connect sometimes. People connect. You see two people, they've met each other for the first time. They've never seen each other before. This is the first time they're meeting each other. And they sit together, and guess what? They blossom. Like, just the relationship is just amazing. You think to yourself, these two individuals have known each other all their life. They've known each other all their life. They've talked, they laugh, they have banter. Subhanallah, you say, have you guys ever met before? No, it's my first time ever meeting him. It's just, there are people like that. When you meet them, you become like that. And there's some people, when you meet them, you just don't feel it. You just, you feel repulsed towards them, okay? And because it's the arwah juludu mujannada ma ta'arafa minha talafa wa ma tanakara min akhtalafa. So I'm not saying be friends with everybody and be in a companionship of everybody. No, I'm not saying that. But I'm saying boycotting, you can't boycott people, and not, you shouldn't come boycott anybody. We don't boycott anybody. And we believe that the concept of Islam is not to boycott anyone. Lakin, if Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's religion is wronged and crimes are committed in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't. We get upset for that. And if it reaches a point where we have to boycott for Allah's religion, we would. ولذلك Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said in the hadith, Umar radiallahu anhu mentioned, Abdullah ibn Umar, sorry, the son of Umar ibn Khattab, Abdullah ibn Umar. One day he said to his son, لا تمنعوا إماء الله مساجد الله وبيوتهن خير لهن. Do not stop the women from going to the masajids, but the houses is better for them. And he told them that this is what the Prophet said. And Ibn Umar attributed this to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam say, do not stop the women from going to the masajids, for verily the masajids are permissible for the women, but their houses are better. Now, one of his sons, he said, I am going to stop them from going to the masajids. And Abdullah ibn Umar became very angry. Like, I told you, the Prophet said. I told you, Rasulullah said. And it was said that Abdullah ibn Umar boycotted his son. Until his death, he boycotted him because of what he did. And this shows you something, that they were, if the deen of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala was wrong, it was a different dealing. But their rights, they saw it to be insignificant. So take that on board, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahu wa bihamdi, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now. Click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.